All right, folks, welcome back. Latest game in AlphaGo versus the world. Chris Garlock back with Michael Redmond, nine non-professional. We are working our way through all 60 games in this amazing series. The challenge for us, and when I say us, I mean Michael, is to give you the major points in these games in under 15 minutes. But also, just to sort of give you a taste of these, will all be included in Volume 2 of AlphaGo 2.0. So, sort of a very effective move there. And who do we have? I see. We're back to
Park. Back to Park Junghwan. So he's back. He played in game number 15, and this is game number 20. He's coming back to challenge AlphaGo again. He actually played a total of 5 games, I think, in this series. And now we're in this game. We're going to see him sort of show his true colors. He's a very dangerous fighter. He plays a fighting game quite often, and he's very sharp in a fight. So we're going to see that, and we're going to see what AlphaGo does with it. So AlphaGo is calling itself Master here. I'm not really clear about the borderlines of when it's calling itself Magist or Magister or Master. It might have been different changing between the servers, just a handle that had on one server and not on the other.
That was my sense, yeah.
But I'm not really following that completely. Obviously, Master is the name that we remembered this version by. And that's what the DeepMind people are calling it also. So Master has the black stones. And Black plays this Kakari. So this is a slightly new opening in this series. And then Black plays the Chinese opening. And this is a point where I just have to marvel at the way that this version of AlphaGo is allowed to play all sorts of moves. Because AI is using the same system, the same network system, generally do not like this move. They don't like to play the Chinese opening. And so it's sort of funny to see AlphaGo playing it because it is a very advanced version of using these networks or systems. And it might be just the fact that it does have some human input in there when it got started. It did learn from human games. But it's developed beyond human. It's superhuman at this point. So you would think that it would have changed to a certain degree, but it still plays the Chinese opening. And White jumps into the 3-3 point. So this is something that would be okay. It's something I think we learned from some of the games that AlphaGo had played in the Lee Sedol version. There were a few games that we got to see. And Black plays here. So this is an opening that, in a way, it was sort of established. It had been played in different games. And Black jumps. So Black is building a big moyo here. The real question was whether Black should have played this stone here or maybe one space to the left. There is a question there. But this is a position that human players would like to play too. This is one of the things about this version of AlphaGo. It's playing openings that that I would have fun playing. That human players general would have fun playing this kind of a big moyo opening. White extends here. And it's looking very much like some of the human games that were played at this time.
I was just thinking this. I mean, if I didn't know better, I would just absolutely think this was a straight-up human-human game.
Yes, it's quite common, and I think the players must have had some experience playing this. But there's something about the way White is going to reduce Black's moyo, which AIs will show us now, but we did not know at the time. So Park played here, and immediately he loses something like 5% points.
Oh, wow.
And it looks like such a normal move, but we're going to see an exquisite attack by Black. But just to show what the AIs say White should have played, it's a pattern that we see over and over again. White just seems to ignore the moyo. And this is something very difficult it would be difficult for me to execute. It's difficult for humans in general to allow Black to develop the moyo this much before diving in. But playing the star point here, this attachment against the star point is sort of like a typically AI move. It's also very effective in this position. Like if black plays down to, this is the strongest attack that black has, taking away white space, stopping white from, for instance, curling into the corner would make it relatively easy for white. So this is taking away the corner eyes from white, but white's just going to play something like this. And it's no problem. No problem when it's an AI playing the moves anyway. And this is something that would be relatively difficult for most human players to execute, especially in a lightning game. We have to remember it's a fairly relatively short time control. But this attachment at the star point that white plays, this is the kind of the key move. It's the move that makes it work. And I don't think that I didn't see that move at the time. I think I might have even done a commentary on this game too. I did a number of the games for AGA, so it might be in your database there on your YouTube channel. But this move definitely was not something that I saw at the time. Instead of playing there, white jumps in here, and black's attack is just so beautiful. Black starts with this, and you can already see black's moyo here. This is the real moyo. Black's going to be satisfied with building on this side of the board. It's already looking really exciting. White jumps out, and black continues here. White jumped down. Otherwise, like Katago was showing me this variation, it's really crazy. Like, this is something that I would not be able to execute. White just throws away all these stones. I'll be going into detail with this in my commentary, but right. Like this is just going to be so confusing. I'm going to have trouble explaining what's going
on. Actually, I remember this game too. It was confusing when we did the more detailed commentary. Right,
And so white is going to, the way this can potentially work for white is going to be so complicated. It would be very, very, very difficult to execute in actual play.
I don't think it's complicated. You just keep on throwing stones into random corners of the board until something
something happens. And something does happen if you're an AI, yeah. So white jumped in here. This is a relatively reasonable-looking move. It's very simple. White's just trying to build a base on the side of the board here. If white continues running out, it would just allow black to continue to build on the center. Like if white was doing stuff like this, black would just be consolidating this big moyo on the right side of the board. And so playing here, white also is sort of hoping to eventually get a counterattack against this black group. But AlphaGo just doesn't give him time to do that. So black plays here and closes the white stones. And this is the kind of position where actually in human-to-human play, this is the kind of position where Park Junghwan is very, very dangerous. And I should say he was dangerous, but he still is. It's a position where he can very sharply counterattack suddenly. And what he's going to try to do that in this game. He slides here, and he jumps here, and he plays this wedge, which is a very sharp move.
Yeah.
And if black had answered on the right, it would have been a relatively even fight. But AlphaGo finds this, refutes it with this, and they get into this wild fight. So this is where you found it sort of complicated. And AlphaGo finds this ugly-looking move. Because if black had opened a liberty, then white would have had an advantage in the race to capture. There's going to be a race to capture on the lower side.
I got to give Park huge credit here. I mean, this is crazy.
But now, in this variation, though, although black looks really ugly, already white's in trouble. Like, just go a few more moves here. White has lost the three stones there on the side, and there was no good way for white to save them. So the way black played, it was not giving an inch, and it was looking a bit ugly, but actually it was very effective. And so I think like 90%, 95, maybe even 99% of the human players would have been squashed by Park Junghwan in this fight.
Oh yeah.
It didn't work for him in this game. And the reason it didn't work is going to take a lot of explaining. So that's the 1 hour version of this video.
There we go.
But I'll go into more detail. This is definitely one of the games I will want to focus on in the book.
Yeah, the squasher gets squashed. I remember this game, and I remember just being blown away. And so, yeah, I can't wait to see the Michael Redmond AI Enhanced Edition for the commentary for the book. All right, folks. Again, we're working our way through all of the Master games, and we will, you stick with it. We will stick with it. So we will see you next time. Thanks for watching.